This is a demonstration of synchronizing the audio and the video of the Canon Vixia HFR600 and the Zoom H2N digital audio recorder using Windows Live Movie Maker and no visual waveforms. What I'm going to do first is to launch Microsoft Excel, and I'll explain why in a moment. But it's sitting there, and now we're going to launch Windows Live Movie Maker. Click here to browse for videos and photos, and I'm going to choose this untitled .wmv file. And let's just play it for a moment. Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N rolling, I'm going to do the audio slate. 1, 2, 3, mark. That's what I'll use to line up the audio when we get ready to synchronize this in post. So that's what we're working with on the video file. And now I'm going to add the audio file, which according to Windows Live Movie Maker is music. So I'm going to add music. And let's pick up this untitled.aif file. And you see it here above the video file. And now let's play the two together.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N.
Now with the video camera and the... And you hear how they're completely different. They're coming at different times. So the first thing I'm going to do is note when that mark falls and note it on my spreadsheet. That's where it falls on the video file, and I'm going to note that as 8.83 seconds. And I'm going to note this on an Excel file, but you could just do it on a piece of scratch paper if you wanted to.
1, 2, 3,
that's what I'll use. Mark. And that's where it falls on the audio file, which is 11.47 seconds. Now, to make sure you hear what I was doing then, let's let these roll again and listen with me for that mark sound.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N
I'm going to do the audio slate. So that's 8.95. I recorded it as 8.83. Not too, it's fine for it to be that far apart. We'll have to adjust it anyway. So that's the mark on the video file, and now let's go find it on the audio file.
1, 2.
That's
three,
what I'll use. Mark. And that's 11.45, and I had noted it as 11.47, so we're close enough. So what that tells me is that if I subtract the difference between these two, that shows me there is 2.64 seconds difference between the two of them. And the audio file is 2.64 seconds behind the video file. So now I'm going to go to Music Tools, and I want to set the start point of the audio file to 2.64. And let's see what we get.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N.
I don't know whether you can hear that difference, but I certainly can. There's a little bit of an echo there. Do you hear that?
I'm going to do the audio slate.
So that tells me we're very close, but not quite there. And I don't know which way to go, so I'm going to try 2.7.
Now with video camera.
And that made it worse. So I'm now going to do 2.6.
Now with the video camera.
Bingo. That sounds good to me. Let's go back and listen to it again.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N rolling, I'm going to do the audio slate. 1, 2, 3, mark.
There actually is a little bitty faint echo there, But I'm okay with that. I'm not going to worry about that little bit of echo because that's close enough. So what that means is I'm now ready to go into my video file, and I can reduce the volume of the video file to zero right up here.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2.
And what we are listening to now, we are seeing the video file from the Canon Vixia HFR 600, and we're hearing the audio from the Zoom H2N. And let's listen to them.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N rolling, I'm going to do the audio slate. 1, 2, 3, mark. That's what I'll use to line up the audio when we get ready to synchronize this in post.
I'm going to append the finished product of this on the end of this video so you can see how it actually looks once you've rendered the movie.
Now with the video camera and the Zoom H2N rolling, I'm going to do the audio slate. 1, 2, 3, mark. That's what I'll use to line up the audio when we get ready to synchronize this in post.
That's how you do it. So I hope you enjoy doing that. Have a great time. Good luck. Take care.